What's up, Coachable family? Welcome back to the Coachable podcast. I'm your host, Tori Gordon, and today is a special episode. We've got Dr. Chau in the house, and I'm so excited to talk to this guy because he is truly the representation of the pursuit and the achievement of the American dream. And so many of you guys out there, I know, are like, your mouths are probably watering, asking, how can I create financial freedom for my life? And that's what we're going to be talking about on this episode of the Coachable podcast, because this is where you get game-changing advice for your life and for your business. And this time it's going to be for your pocketbook. So let's jump in. Welcome to the show, Dr. Chau.
Thank you so much for having me, Tori. I love your podcast. I love all the audience. Thank you so much for having me.
Absolutely. I know. I was just saying before we got into this, I'm so impressed by, first of all, the way you look. Your jacket is very nice and you look amazing. But your resume and your background is super impressive. So you've got an MBA. You also have a doctorate in pharmacy. That's why you are Dr. Chau. And you've been able to create not only financial freedom for yourself and your family, but retire in your 30s through an alternate and non-traditional path, if you will. And I would love to dive into what that looks like. So you're in the real estate business, but it's a little bit different than what we think of as traditional real estate, where we have to have all of this money up front, capital up front to invest and purchase properties. Talk to me about what you call corporate housing arbitrage. What is that? And how were you able to utilize it to create financial freedom?
Absolutely. So if I may share a little bit about my background, because most of the audience maybe don't know me. So I came from Vietnam, a very poor third world country. We come to America with absolutely nothing.
Yeah.
And we had to sleep on one mattress, my mom, my dad, me and my sister. We had to make everything doable, you know, to make a living. We couldn't even know any English. So you can imagine how hard it is.
How old were you when you
I was 10 years old.
Okay.
Yeah. And I remember looking up dictionary for 2 hours every night just to know the assignment. And we grew up in the worst neighborhood possible. I would hear gunshots when I go to school. But I promised myself, because I see my mom crying herself to sleep every night, I promised myself, Tori, that one day I will take care of her. I will retire you, mom. And I'll do whatever it takes. No matter what, as long as legal, moral, ethical, and I would make that happen for you and buy you a dream home and take you around the world. So I went to school. It was really rough. You know, grew up in the South, that you can imagine. There's no diversity.
Yeah.
It was really tough. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Yeah. But anyway, we made it work and become the doctor that everybody, want, right? Because that's what we've been told or programmed.
Was that what was kind of expected of you growing up?
Yes, yeah. yes. Welcome to the Asian world. Mm-hmm. You know, you're not talking about.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, but, you know, I was always an entrepreneur by heart. At 10 years old, I was selling candy in school, pixie sticks, all the little things that I can do, trading Pokemon cards.
Me too.
All the stuff. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, to just make some extra money and help out, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, so I was told to be a doctor and I did the path. I become a doctor of pharmacy, got my MBA as well, got 4.0 GPA, the whole thing.
Wow.
You know, study 60 hours a week all the time and work on top of that. And when I got out, I thought I made it. I got a white coat. I got all the everything and everywhere I can dream of.
Mm-hmm.
And then I climbed the corporate ladder. Within my first year, I actually won the Pharmacy of the Year award.
Wow.
For a Fortune 5 company.
Incredible.
Yes. And I thought I made it. I'm like, mom, I'm going to take care of you. I'm going to retire you now. You don't have to worry about a thing. Dad, I got you. All of that. What I learned was they gave me more work, same amount of pay, like a 2% raise, and then less help. They cut my help hours, my tech hours by half, because they know that I can handle it.
Yep.
Right? And they want to basically suck more out of the blood out of me. And on the other side is I see that a pharmaceutical is not the right path. As you know, the audience well aware, you know, it's definitely one of my last resort options.
Right.
There's a lot of better options out there. And I see how corrupted the pharmaceutical industry is.
Yeah.
And I decided I don't want anything to do with that.
Right.
So then I started really focusing on how can I get my financial freedom to really fulfill all my promises to my loved one. So I started to do all kinds of businesses from MLM.
You never know what could happen. We'll see you next week on the Coachable Podcast.